In this video, we'll have a look at how to install a single wall switch, which takes a single space, to control both fan speed and fan light. This scenario assumes that there is only one switch controlling the fixture. We'll also run through a few common variations. If you have a black wire coming from the switch as opposed to a black screw post, we'll also look at a variation where you may be working with two individual sets of wires that are coming down. For example, if you're replacing a double switch that was controlling the ceiling fan and ceiling fan light. Before doing any electrical work, always be sure to cut all power to the fixture and to the electrical box by turning off and flipping the breaker. Some tools you want to have on hand, I like to have a slot screwdriver, Phillips, a red and green handle Robertson, some pliers, which also are wire cutters, some wire strippers, flashlight, and electrical tape, and some wire nuts or morettes. Now, starting with your line in, which is your live wire, your power source, the white from your line in is going to go to the white of your load out, which is the one going to the fixture. Your bare copper wire, which is your grounds, will be connected together along with the green from the switch. If your switch doesn't have an existing green, then make a pigtail and put that pigtail on, as well as there should be a ground coming from your junction box, which may be in the form of a pigtail as well. So all those coppers will be connected. The switch itself may vary on the specifics of what they designate for light and what they designate for fan. In our case, the switch has designated red for light, yellow for fan. Double check your instructions for that. Make sure that you're specific to your switch. So here I'm going to take my red light, and in my three wire, my red happens to be the one that is going to my light in the fan. So those will be connected together. And then I've got my yellow fan wire that they've specified from the switch, and that will go to my wire, which I have going to my fan motor. Again, that could vary for your setup. You have to know what is connected on the other side. So in my scenario, I've got red going to my fan light, and I've got black going to my fan motor. So again, here, light to light, motor to motor. So that leaves us just with our black from our line in, and this is the hot wire that's giving us our electricity. So that is going to be connected to the screw post on the switch. So when we have all our connections together, we can see we've got our white coming from our line in, our power source, to our white of our loadout, to our fixture, our black, our hot wire, going to the black screw post. We've got all our grounds together, and also there should be a ground that's connecting to the electrical box. They'll all be one there. In our scenario, and as specified for this switch, our red light going to the wire that I have to my light fixture, and then the yellow fan motor going to the wire that I have to my fan motor. Again, these two could vary on your setup. You need to know which goes to the light, which goes to the motor. Now, let's take a look at a little variation. So, now, our first variation, I have another switch here which controls the ceiling fan speed, the switch on the side, and then the light just as an on-off with no dimmer. Now this one doesn't have the same screw post that the other one had. It's got a black wire instead. So all of our other connections will be exactly the same, except that this black wire will now go to the line in hot. So wire it up, all up, and you'll have a look. One thing to note for this switch, actually the color of the wires are specified as different from the other one. So for this switch, the yellow goes to the light and the red goes to the fan motor. So again, check the specifics of your switch and the specifics of your ceiling wiring, which one goes to light and which one goes to fan motor. So now with this wired up, we see our black line in, our hot wire, to our black from our switch. Our whites together, our grounds together, and again, there'll be another ground from the junction box. They're all connected together. Here I've got my designated light wire going to my light of my ceiling fan setup. And I've got my designated red wire going to my designated motor, ceiling fan motor wire. So it could be that you had a double switch in your wall that you're replacing that control the ceiling fan, and you've got two sets of two wired. So there again, you want to be sure you know which one is for the motor, which one is for the light. One thing that I find helpful is when you know which is which, before you disconnect everything, if possible, or immediately after disconnecting, just put a little label on it. For example, let's say this is our light. And then I'm going to remember that. And then in that scenario, this is our fan motor. So that makes it a little easier to keep straight. So if that's the case, really the only thing that we're going to need to do here, everything's going to be hooked up like before, except that we've got an extra white to white and an extra ground to gang together. So in that scenario where we have two separate two wires coming from the fan and light, again, we've got our black, our hot line in, going to our screw post or our black wire, depending on our switch itself. We've got all of our whites together. So we've got the white of our line in and each white of our load out connected together. We've got all of our grounds together, the green wire from the switch, all of our bare coppers from the three sets of wires. And we'll have another one, a pigtail from the electrical box, all connected together. We've got our light, switch designated light wire to our light. And we've got our switch designated fan motor wire to our motor. When you've got everything hooked up, it's a good idea to remove any of these papers. Okay, so here's our fan switch that controls our fan motor speed and our light. Our single switch, our line in is coming from the top here. We've got our black going to our black screw post. We've got our light. This is for our light, the load out. This is for our fan motor, the load out. And all of our whites are ganged together here. I've got multiple switches happening, so don't worry about that so much. Just gang your whites together. And then all of the grounds are ganged together here and grounded off to the box. When the work is all done, you've got your faceplate on, turn your breaker back on, and voila.